So what we argued was that given a matrix A, we should first compute the QR factorization and then take this matrix R and focus on computing the singular value decomposition of that upper triangular matrix. So what I'm going to do in this video is say, okay, let's take that matrix R, but actually let's go back and let's just call it A. And now what we're going to do is we're going to say our matrix A is square. That's the important part. Okay? The next step towards computing the singular value decomposition now is to say, okay, I've got this square matrix A. I'm going to find unitary matrices UA and VA in such a way that UA Hermitian A VA is a bidiagonal matrix. A bidiagonal matrix is a matrix with the diagonal and then only the superdiagonal. How can we do that? Well, let's let this represent our matrix. Okay? We know how to compute a householder transformation, H0, from this first column right here, such that when we apply it from the left to the entire matrix, these elements become zero, and then the rest of the elements change appropriately. We saw that already when we talked about using householder transformations to compute the QR factorization. Now, we can now apply different householder transformations from the right. When we reduced to tridiagonal form, we had to apply the same householder transformation from the right, and as a result, these zeros would then be filled in had we chosen this householder transformation to place zeros right here. So what if instead we compute a different householder transform? Let's call it H0 hat. In such a way that this matrix that resulted has zeros right here. So what we do is we look at this vector right here. Well, it's a row vector, but we can pretend that it's a column vector because when we apply from the right to a row, that's the same as applying the transpose from the left to the column. So we can compute this householder transform from this vector in such a way that we get zeros right here, and then apply that householder transform to the rest of the matrix. Okay, so really what we have is we started with A, we computed H0, we computed H0 hat, and now we get this matrix right here. All right, now you can see where this is going. We can next look at this and say what householder transform introduces zeros right there. We'll call that H1. And then we can loop from the right and say what householder transform introduces zeros right here. And we keep going back and forth. And upon completion, what we have is the bidiagonal matrix that we desired. Okay. And then obviously you can multiply all of these householder transforms together to get these matrices, or we can take all of these householder transforms and apply them to the appropriate matrices, for example, our matrix Q. There are different ways of going about that. So now we're left with having to find the singular value decomposition of this bidiagonal matrix B.